change will be inevitable. It is inevitable and indeed gratifying to see all of our students in this graduating class and how they have matured and how they are ready to tackle their future and their lifelong education. It is inevitable that the structures and processes and relationships will change in their day-to-day lives. It is inevitable that they will face new challenges, and it is inevitable that things may seem different in the year ahead. As we look back at their journey, it is one that started out with tentative steps, and now we can see just how far these young ladies and gentlemen have progressed. It has been an honor and a privilege being part of their journey, even though I have only been part of this journey with them for 1 year. However, that 1 year has been filled with wonderful memories, and I would like to share just a few of those. I remember one of the first things I had to do was go to Sarah's photography studio so I could have my picture taken. There were several of our young ladies participating in ball sports who had heard that I was coming, and so they hung around just so they could meet me. Once I was there, it was a swarm of very hyper and excited young people, and I knew that there was no way I was going to remember every single one of these students and their names. However, the first day of school, I went around to the different classrooms, and I was welcoming kids, and I saw one young lady, and I knew I had seen her there. I was like, oh, hey, glad to see you again. And she gave me a smile, and she just looked at me kind of strange, and I was like, well, okay, she might be as good as me. That's good news for me. It took me about a week to figure out that she was actually a twin, and that I, in fact, had never met her. I had met the other McGuire twin that day. She looked quite a bit confused, but I was like, all right, you know. Then there was another young lady that very afternoon, and we were standing out waiting on the buses, and she struck up a conversation with me, and her whole conversation was about promising me how she was going to do well this year and all the different things she was going to do to be successful. And after a small time into our conversation, I was like, well, no doubt, if you put forth all that effort, that you're going to do just fine. The same student later came to the office and promised me that when she was rich and famous and on TV, she was going to say my name and Mrs. Ott's name so that we could be remembered, and I would look forward to that. Just saying, I'm going to tell you this is in a minute. Through many of the ups and downs of this young lady and several conversations later, Quinn ran into my office not too long ago, gave me a smile and hug, and said she had indeed reached her goal and would be graduating. And then there was Jasmine, who I remember having the biggest, warmest smile, being full of spirit, and she never failed to lose that spirit. And anytime she'd see me, she was always so happy and willing to greet me and make me feel welcome. Richie Josh, who, before he becomes a famous producer, I will remember as an alien because he did such an outstanding job in the play. But perhaps I will just remember him as the kid who took over Grandparents Day so I did not have to make any closing remarks. Michaela. Michaela, she tricked us all by becoming Mrs. Delcoma's doppelganger on stage in a musical. We all felt like Mrs. Delcoma was up there playing the part rather than her. And last but certainly not least, Johnny B. Johnny B comes to see Mr. Henry and myself daily, just to make sure that we have things covered and under control. And even though he has bad days, he does tell us about those and he accepts responsibility and tells us how he's going to correct his actions. Yet he still makes time to ask Mr. Henry and I if we are doing fine and if everything is okay. These are just a few of the memories these young men and women have given me, but there are memories that speak to the core fundamentals of these students. And all those things will rightfully change for them. The character of this graduating class exhibits is a testament to the fine caliber of these young men and women. I would like to pay tribute to each and every one of them. We have all left and will continue to leave a legacy. this time, we have several graduating students who have joined the military. I would like to take a moment to recognize them. So if you have committed yourself to the military, would you please stand up?
Not like this put limits on what we will do. When I think about the future,
want to make it our dream home. Always try to remember and support this place we all call home. With that being said, I want to thank the administrators, teachers, coaches, family, and community as a whole. You have instilled in us all the characteristics we need to foster. You have given us the courage to dare, the confidence to believe in ourselves, and the knowledge we need to excel. You have been there when we doubted ourselves and wanted to give up. You have shown us the importance of pursuing our dreams. So I say to you, our success is your success. From the 2017 graduates, I thank every single one of you. As I close, I want us graduates to remember one thing. The dreams we have been dreaming will not come easy. We will have to work for them. We will make mistakes and we will learn from them. The future holds many uncertainties. Use those uncertainties as opportunities. Every single one of you sitting before me today has the capability of accomplishing great things. Whether these accomplishments are known to the whole world or kept to yourself within the depths of your heart. As Glenda, never give up, as you never know how close you are to accomplishing your dreams. Eleanor Roosevelt once said, "The future belongs to those who believe the beauty of their dreams." The future belongs to us, graduates. Let us never forget the wise words of Jonathan. We are more fulfilled when we are involved in something bigger than ourselves. So congratulations, fellow graduates. Happy graduation. Whichever path you have chosen after today, may the future be the time where you can accomplish all.
Many of us try to fit in with the cool upperclassmen who really weren't all that cool. The year is 2013, and that's when the Harlem Shake, Sharknado, and Frozen were all the rage. Hashtag YOLO. What a year. Upon reflecting on all four of my years of high school, I think freshman year was one of the best. There were a lot of firsts that year. Our first home football game. Our first pep rally. Our first homecoming. Talk about a culture shock. Our first Clay Olympics, and realizing that the teachers are much more competitive than we thought. Freshman year did have a lot of firsts, but before we knew it, the year had passed by, and we're on to our second year of high school, sophomore year. The year is 2014. Even though it's our second year in high school, we think we have it all figured out. By this time, we can safely navigate the halls, and at this point, we begin to wish our life away. We think, oh, I can't wait until that test is over with, or I can't wait until next year. And before we know it, it's our junior year. And honestly, this was my hardest year in high school. The year is 2015, and you get to that moment where you're so close to your final year, but it's so far away. Junior year, the classes get harder, and the tests get trickier. And graduates, you know what I'm talking about. When you log into Progress Book your junior year, and you click on your grades, and you go, what are those? At this point, you actually have to start thinking about your future, and it's scary. It's scary to think about your future. And each year of high school gets faster and faster, and before you know it, it's 2016, and we're starting our final year of high school. Many of us are already doing what we love. Some have found their place in the workforce. Others this year take themselves to the max by taking advantage of College Credit Plus or going full-time up at Kent State or attending Buckeye to learn a trade. Before we know it, the year is 2017. And somehow, Donald Trump is our president and I'm the valedictorian. Hashtag, we did it. So now what? Now what do? Our whole lives, the only thing we've ever known is coming to school. For 13 years, we get up early, really early. And we come to school, go to class, have recess, go back to class, then go homework, go home and have homework, and then we would repeat. Now what do? Class of 2017, if you remember one thing from the speech, remember this. It's only two words. Are you ready? Dream big. My whole life, I characterize myself as a dreamer. I have had huge aspirations. Growing up, when my family would attend a family vacation or go someplace, I would always come home and want to replicate that event. If we go to a NASCAR race, I would set up a NASCAR track in the basement and have the whole family help. Or when we went to Nicaragua for a missions trip, we got stranded in Miami. Then we hopped from airport to airport. We called it our airport vacation, but it wasn't a week after I had Hannah and I playing airport in the backyard. I like to recreate my events, but I'm a dreamer. Like 2 years ago, when I started writing the script for this movie, I would have never thought that it would show at the Quaker Cinema and have 5 sellout showings. Now, you're probably thinking, well, I think to myself, I'm a dreamer, but you're probably thinking I'm weird. But that's okay. Sometimes in life, you have to be weird. The reason I'm telling you this class is I encourage you to dream big. First, do what you can't. You can't make a full-length movie while in high school. You can't run for public office when you're 18. You can't be successful unless you go to college. Or you can't go to college because you're not smart enough or you don't have the money. To that I say, do what you can't. Stand up to the doubters, the haters, the people that don't believe in you. Because guess what? You can. Dream big, my friends. You're now a graduate from Claymont High School. You have a heritage and family roots unlike any other. 922. You have what it takes to succeed. Dream big. Do what you can't. Persevere. I hate to break it to you, but life isn't easy. Adulting, it's hard. There are going to be challenges come along your way, but you can't give up. Each and every one of you is made with a purpose. Writer Sydney Smith once said, obstacles are those frightful things that you see when you take your eyes off the goal. Dream big. Do what you can't. Persevere. And finally, stay focused. There are so many distractions around us, and many things to take our eyes off our goal. Social media is a huge distraction. Now, I know you get defensive over your Instagram and Snapchat, but I'm right there with you too. It's tempting, but it is a distraction. Don't forget to live in the moment. But in order to dream big, you have to set goals. Standing up here in front of you has been a goal of mine for a very long time. By no means does it mean that I'm smarter or better than any one of you. Just because I have the highest GPA doesn't make me perfect. For example, I still have to do this. Siri, I just spelled valedictorian. I never said that was good at spelling. In closing, I now realize that graduation is actually three different occasions all wrapped up into one event. See, graduation is a celebration, a farewell, and a new beginning. It's a moment in which we get to look back and reflect upon our 4 years of high school. We can celebrate and cherish all the wonderful memories, the laughs, and experiences that have occurred. While graduation is a celebration, it's also a farewell. It's a time for us to say goodbye to teachers that we've all known and loved. But it's also a time to say goodbye to our classmates that some we may never see again. Finally, graduation is also a celebration and a farewell, but it's a new beginning. Class of 2017, we have our whole lives ahead of us. Take a moment right now. Think about your new beginning. I encourage you to dream big. Do what you can't. Persevere and stay focused. Be kind. Speak the truth. Give generously. Love others. Work hard. Show grace. Choose joy. Pray together. Be grateful. Stay positive. Forgive others. Follow Christ. That's most important. Today, May 21st, 2017, this very day, let me leave you with one of my favorite scriptures found in Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to promise.
Sure. I want you to repeat these three things to him. Number one, I love you.
I love you, Pep Rose.